Welcome to the video radio experiments. Well, this is another attempt to build a FM receiver. And the problem with FM receivers is that you would need to have the demodulator for FM, which is really annoying. So as you can see, oh, so much stuff going on. Here I have my tuner. These are all BF199. Here I have the local oscillator, input amplifier and mixer. That goes to my IF filter and IF amp and to my so-called discriminator. What is a discriminator? Well, in old radios you will find a circuit that is called ratio detector. And you have two coils that can be tuned, two tunable coils, and on the output of each coil there is a diode. And you have to tune them that the phase of the signal is shifted, because you have FM, so you get AM again, which can be then, as it is being used here, demodulated by a diode. Since I don't want to use these special coils, because they usually design stuff that can be rebuilt, I've made a discriminator circuit that does the phase shift with a coil, but with a standard coil and a variable capacitor. Now everything is aligned properly, and it kinda does work. There's still some distortion, but that's the problem because of the position of the antenna and everything. I can get a more or less non-distorted signal if I align it properly, but there's just some demonstration. So I'll turn up the volume. Here's the loudspeaker, just a boring LM386 audio amp. And then you will be able, at least in theory, the potentiometer just went out. So it's not tuned. I'll tune it. Dodgy wire. That's breadboard stuff is... Come on. So I tune it. So this is a local radio station. No distortion can be heard.
Vermisst ist wegen der Zerstörung historischer Kulturgüter in Timbuktu dem internationalen Strafgerichtshof.
So as you can hear, there's still some distortion.
Der Mann stammt aus Mali und war in Niger festgenommen.
I'll try to get a better signal.
Als führendes Mitglied einer Rebellengruppe 10
so it depends on the signal strength.
Zerstört haben. Die Heiligtümer gehörten zum
so this is the discriminator. If I turn it, if I make more capacitance, you will get a rather narrow-banded filter. So I turn it up, and now I have a very narrow-banded filter. So it's too narrow. The filter is too narrow. I turn the thing in the other direction. So what happens is the filter is too narrow. Now I'll make it in the opposite direction, like that. Now we have a very wide-banded filter. It will distort. It won't get demodulated properly. There you can see we have a carrier signal. Here's static. Now I'll tune it in. We have a carrier signal and it's getting more silent. Well, that's because the thing is that you have amplitude modulation. And if I make this filter with too much feedback, it distorts because the filter is getting smaller than the than the frequency, the amount of frequency that is being shifted. And if I make it to, if I don't have any feedback at all, it just is an AM receiver. And if you receive a FM signal on an AM receiver, it just doesn't work. So what I'm doing is I'm aligning it on a level, which I know the position is round about here. Where the phase is shifted. So there are two signals now. A signal that is coming from the IF stage and a signal that is fed back phase shifted to the input of the IF stage from one of the output amplifiers. And the result is that we change FM signal into AM signal. And then if I connect the speaker again and tune it in, you will be able to hear. And if there aren't dodgy contacts, okay, this is not very well aligned.
Die Regierung jedenfalls sagt, das Besteigen des Mount Everest ist wieder genauso sicher wie vor den schweren Bögen.
Okay, I think I've unaligned it. So I need to find the right spot. That's very critical. There we go. Little bit more filter. So it sounds a little bit like the TDA 7000. I'm using a very low IF, it's like 500 kHz. Usually it would be 10.7 MHz. There we go. So this is a station, 100 watts in 1 kilometer. 100 watts in 1 kilometer. And this station.
For sure, that's a mountaineering is dangerous.
I have to make a little bit. So, this is a station with 10 kilowatts and I think 15 or 16 kilometers, but no line of sight. So I try to tune a different station. This is my local oscillator.
Das war jetzt meine erste Assoziation.
Das ist ein schönes Bild, ja. Aber es ist halt auch was von so Lounge-Musik. Bis da dieser nervige Synthi eingegriffen hat.
So. Ja, jetzt.
Palmen gesehen, ganz kurz. Aber es ist dann schnell wieder nach Regenwetter und den Dingen.
A little bit more Finterbelt with. I want to get this one undistorted.
Aber es ist so, als ob sie ihn verwenden im gewohnten Kontext.
A little bit more filtered. So this is where you can play around. So this is my, if you want to call it like that, ratio detector.
Ein großer weißer Umschlag mit Bettina in ihrer kunstvollen Schrift Überraschungsmusik draufgeschrieben und Felix, du hast die große Ehre bei deiner Musik in die Pause reinzugucken, was es ist. Ich bin echt gespannt.
So now it's nearly undistorted.
Hier steht's.
Und es ist
Titel des Songs. Bugs, Beat and Bowties.
So I don't know what station this is. I think it's Bayern 2. But I can't check it right now.
Und jetzt kommt's.
Okay, so as you can hear it works. So building a FM receiver is really critical or difficult. Building an AM receiver is easy. Can you make your superhead circuit, which is there, which is just the main superhead circuit. And then you can have your IF stage. But the problem... not the problem. On AM receiver, then you can add a diode and then you can demodulate the signal, everything is fine. But the problem is on these FM radios. Normal FM radios, you have this FM modulation. And there are two ways to demodulate it. The first way is that you can tune your circuit. For example, I'm using the Samsung logo. Here is the radio station frequency in the black part. And here is your filter. And what you are going to do is that you are aligning your filter a little bit onto the edge of the radio station. Not perfect on the radio station, you're aligning it a little bit on the edge of the station. And what then happens, since frequency modulation, the frequency goes like this, so it's jumping up and down. Every time the frequency jumps, it gets a little bit into your filter range. And that causes the radio to receive the signal a little bit better and a little bit worse. And that works. Because you have the varying current. And the problem with this is that it's very hard to align and also the audio quality ain't that good. And the more professional ways and the way a common radio does it, it mixes down the frequency usually to 10.7 MHz. As I said, I'm using around 500 kHz IF, which is way too low, but I'm using a different design anyway. So they're mixing it down to 10.7 MHz and then they amplify the signal and they have their so-called ratio detector. As I said before, there are two coils that can be tuned, two coils, and on each output of one coil, you have one diode that is in this direction and you have a diode that is in this direction. Then you have aligned the coils that the phases are shifted in the right way, so on the diodes you will get more or less amplitude modulation, which then gets demodulated and gets turned back into an audio signal. This is the way that I'm using here. Instead of having these ratio detector coils, I do have some coils that I probably can use for a ratio detector, but I don't want to use them because it should be rebuildable. The thing that I built here is just with two coils, and this is like some kind of active ratio detector because the signal is actively phase shifted and fed back to this input amp, and so you get two signals. And under this small capacitor here, you can see the diode, which is then demodulating the audio signal. There's no schematic since this is just prototyping around, but as you can see, I'm getting somewhere. The last part that you could hear was nearly undistorted. So it's really just tricking and playing around with the values. They are very critical. And as you can also see, this variable capacitor really affects the performance of the overall system quite much, because this is aligning the phase shift and you have to find a good compromise. Well, I don't know, I'm just translating the word compromiss into English, and I think it's probably compromise, because I'm sure this word means something else, but you have to find, if you are using too less feedback, won't get FM demodulation and you won't have phase shift. If you're using too much feedback, you will have phase shift, but on the other side you get a very narrow banded filter where the modulation is wider than the bandwidth of the filter and it distorts. So you have to find the right angle on which you get some phase shifting and you get some good filter bandwidth. So this is my FM radio just with a boring LM386 audio amp. So this is my FM radio, superhead receiver, prototyping, experimenting around with FM radio circuits. So I haven't watched this one on the web, but this is just pretty much my own design, if you want to call it like that. And I had problems with this feedback network and I just found out I need a really high gain IF amp, which is this 3-transistor circuit there, to get it working. So no AGC problems, I can hear the station that has 100 watts in 1 kilometer distance, which comes in really strong here because it's pretty much line of sight. And I also can receive the 10 kilowatt transmitters from the official radio stations, but although they're having 10 kilowatts, they are pretty much not in line of sight. There are some mountains in between and they come in still quite strong, but dozens of dBs weaker than the 100 watts transmitter. Okay, the FM radio project. Best regards, Stefan.